In this video, we will deploy our demo Drupal application using Helm chart. And we will also use the ingress so that we can access the URL on the browser directly. So before we use ingress, we need to install or we need to deploy the ingress controller on our cluster. So here I am using the Google Kubernetes cluster. And on that, this is already installed. I have already ran this command. And after that, I can see the pods are running for that particular controller. Like you can see that these three things are running. And when you run this command, and if you go to your cloud platform, your console, then you can see in the networking services, the load balancing, you should be able to see that one load balancer is running that is being used by all the other Helm applications which we will be installing. So now to install the Drupal, we will use the Helm chart. So this is the Helm chart that you can use, like bitnami/Drupal. And here you can provide your release name basically. So I'm using here Drupal test. So once you, when you run just this command, this will install the Drupal application with default configurations. Whatever they will provide you, that will get installed. In case you want to customize it according to your project need, you can use that values.yaml file. So here you can see that I have this values.yaml file. So I have just taken the default one from their GitHub repo. And after that, you can customize it. You can change any parameters which you want to change. Here, I am just changing the ingress because I am enabling the ingress as true. And here you can see that hostname is drupal.local. So this is the only change that I have done so that I can access it on the browser. So now just run this. Okay, so let me just run this command, helm install Drupal test. Okay, sorry, I'm not in the correct GitHub repo. So let me just go here, Drupal demo application, and let me just run this command from here. You can ignore this error. This is specific to my machine. Okay, so now you can see that your Helm application for Drupal is installed, and here you can see the status, and it will take a little bit of time before you can actually browse it, but it has provided you all the details like how you can access it, how to get the username and how to get the password. And you can also check using kubectl get pods. If I do this, so you can see that Drupal, and it is still running, container is getting created. You can see kubectl get service. So here you can see that it is creating this. Okay. And here I can see kubectl get, you can also do the get deployments. So you will be able to see that it has created this deployment also. It's not ready yet. So basically with the Helm, you don't have to create different YAML files for the deployment, for the service, for anything. Everything is automatically get created with just one command. So that is the reason people started using Helm, because it requires very less configurations. And you can do this kubectl get ingress. So this is important. So yes, so here you can see that this is the host and this is the IP. So, and you can also check the logs, kubectl describe ingress Drupal.local. So here you can, sorry, I have provided the wrong name. So here it's, Drupal test hyphen Drupal. And here you can see all the logs. In case of any errors, then you will see the error here, and accordingly you can fix it. If you have service configure is not properly in your values.yaml, is there any issues, your ingress is not configured properly, then you might see some errors. Okay, so now I need to first do this entry also. To access this URL, as soon as it's available, I need to make this entry. So let me just do sudo FBI etc host. Okay, so here you can see that I have lot of entries. You can also check again if something has changed. Okay, so let me just try if I can access it now or not. Okay, it's not yet, it's not up yet, so maybe it will take a little bit of time before it comes up. Okay, yeah, now you can see that it's up. You can click on login, you can put the username. The username here you can see what is the username, user, and also from your values.yaml, and you can also get the password. So we can see, so let me just get my password using this command and just copy it. And this is my user and this is the password. So here you can see that I am able to log into the Drupal application. So this is how we can use Helm, and this is how you can use the customized values.yaml file with your configuration instead of using the default configuration. Thank you.